Hello, Africa and Zambia. Welcome to the application of the Takunda Law of Economics, an invention by us Africans for Africans. You know, Africa, our development has always been in us. The problem is our educational structure and everything has caused us to be looking to the outside. So, welcome to the presentation which I say how to make money without money. This is actually wealth creation. Now, the wealth of a country is based in the value of its chiefs, not in the value of its government. The government system which the colonial masters left us is what actually destroyed us. They invented what are called tribes, capitalism, invented what is called separation of the classes, something which we never had. So all our economic freedom lies in us turning ourselves to be equal, removing the tribes, removing the borders, which are actually imaginary places. So Africa, it's living together that is going to help us. We are not a religious grouping, we are an economic movement. So we are inviting Muslims, Hindus, Christians, whatever you worship, atheists, to join into this. For this is the future of our continent and of our children's children's children up to the generations that will come until the proposed end of the world comes. So the Takunda Law states that you can create wealth from anything as long as you know the value of what is around you and the value of what you have in your hand. You see, the other economic modules like the American module and the Chinese module are capital based, and they actually depend on the banking system for you to develop. But this new economic module actually creates the banking system, our own banking system. So the Takunda economic module states that in the first block we have talent and trends, in the second block you have land and heritage, and in the third block we have the value of what is around you and your care for others. So as you have seen, no money has been mentioned. Now let me put these things into practice by what we call Project Nzamani, for it is starting in my father, Chief Nzamani's area. So here we go, and welcome to this presentation. Chief Nzamani's area is the senior chief of the Ngoni people. So it is at his chiefdom that the famous Nkwala ceremony is held. So in an off-the-record discussion with him yesterday, he told me, he said that there's no lodging place for people who come for the Nkwala. People have to stay in Chipata, Rwangwa, some as well as far as Malawi, just watch Chief Mpezeni do his ceremonial movements. And people even from Zimbabwe have to fly from Zimbabwe on the daily to do the Nkwala. And he told me that it takes about 6 months to prepare for. So imagine the cost of moving around. So he suggested, he said he wants to build something in his area. So once he placed it in my hands, then I consulted Mrs. Elizabeth Olodemi, and she proposed some tent arrangement. For those people who are coming from outside the continent, because then they would prefer watching the stars, the savannah beauty. But then those who are coming from within would prefer sleeping in an expensive hotel. So uniting these two things together, and with the Libra project, this is all part of the Libra project. The other details I'll discuss later. So the aim is that we are going to turn the whole country into a hotspot. The company that is going to do this is called SmartNet Limited. I just spoke with the Chief Executive Officer Wareka Senge in the morning. Do you know that Zambia, we can link ourselves to the optic fiber connection as in instantly? This company is the one which did the job for ZESCO. So now once we have the optic fiber connection, the whole country can be turned into a wireless hotspot, meaning communication between the Zambian and the outside world will be on fingertip stage. So imagine literacy levels in 4 years will change. Then now we are going to introduce what is called e-learning. So there will be no need now to build blocks, and we are going to introduce e-banking at the same time. So all these systems will be virtual. So all we are going to have now are pleasure resorts and farms. Imagine if each sector of Zambia or each sector of Africa, the land was utilized, then we have the lowest cost of living ever, but the highest standard of living the world has ever seen. You see, our natural resources are nearby, but we've been following a structure day by day. So we are going to structure as the Libra team the way you handle your stock market and the way you handle your currency exchanges. So here we go now. At Chifton Zamani's area, we are going to go there and browse the area. I've contacted Hopeful Aluminium. These are people who have invested in building glass buildings. So welcome to seeing the skyscraper, the first Zambia ever glass building start construction in Chifton Zamani's area. So for the civils, we've contacted Dimwa Engineering Limited. All these are Zambian firms. For media, it's the Daily Mail. For business organization, it's the ZDA. For the initial financial startup, it's the Bank of Zambia. And for starting it everywhere, we've contacted the Ministry of Home Affairs. So now, with the chiefs now in place, then we have the industry. Now, the structure of the chiefdom is going to be, each chiefdom is going to be an independent business unit. You see, we are going to grow high-value crops like marijuana, soya beans, groundnuts. These marijuana people is a product of every cosmetic and every drug that you have in hospital. That's why it's a trillion-dollar industry. It's not for the smokers, as we have put it in Zambia. Let's learn to listen to a change of idea. So now what is going to happen at Chifton Zamani's area, which is the subject of the matter, is we're going to invite the graphic designers from SmartNet who are going to come and give us a 3D image of how this is going to work. Here the aim is not to spend money, but to achieve a huge project. Like I'll explain later in another presentation how the structure of the chiefdom becomes an independent business unit, but this concentration is on this project. So what is going to happen is the graphic designer is going to give us the overview after we make the trip. The Bank of Zambia is just going to give us a 50,000 kwacha. That is all that is required to start this. This is what I call project engineering. A project plan is always achievable. Business plan, you start saying it will cost us billions of dollars, blah, blah, blah. But watch the introduction to project engineering. The 50,000 from BOS is just to facilitate the trips and the feasibility studies, that's all. So once the graphic designer gives us the 3D image, the chiefdom business unit will only float 10% of itself on the international stock market. There now, the investors who stole the money from us now are going to pay us for our development by just buying into 10% to do this brilliant idea. So now, once we float these shares, where 10% means we're still in charge. So now the money is going to come in to start the construction. This is where Zambia has to work together. So we are going to call for a conference. So now once this beautiful arrangement is seen, and then space is bid for business, then now we'll start the construction. So now that we're going to be a hotspot, we're going to brilliantly e-market this thing to the rest of the world. Now imagine the influx of people who are going to want to be part of this. So it's a done deal, simple and easy. So only a change of mindset. Now, since I'm representing the chiefs on this one, I'm a prince of the Chewa people, we in the chiefs, we just speak. So we can start this instantly across Zambia. And believe me, in 2 months' time, Zambia will be a different place. So I'm calling on COMESA now to open the trade barriers as they already opened. Let's now think of feeding COMESA. Imagine we're going to be packaging groundnuts and sending them to America. We're going to be packaging corn and sending it to America. So thank you very much. And I hope that you can contact us. Our offices are at Dream Valley here. My phone numbers are 0954-091670. This has been Professor Samson Tembo. Thank you very much.